Just say action.
Rolling and action.
We are the Milestone Theater Company.
Oh, man. Well, it's about the problems parents encounter when they think their kid might have ADHD.
Her name is Vera. She's a 40-year-old suburban mother with OCD on Prozac.
It's kind of like a story about life, I guess, if you think about it. It's about a mom and a child.
Let's see. My character is Dad, so he's supposed to have all the answers, right? But he doesn't.
I think, well, after working on the play, I think everyone has these. Like, I love to hear myself talk. I like broccoli. Well, I play four different parts in myself, but very medicated, a great character. It would have been helpful if my parents had seen a play like this, and they probably would have medicated me. I don't know.
It's a play about a child with an attention deficit disorder and his family, his parents trying to figure out how to cure him.
Okay, let's just be distracted because I'm in it and because Justin's in it.
I thought you were gonna walk by.
Go for it.
Well, I know it in my head. I'll describe what I think it is. Distracted is a play about a family and their son having ADD and they're trying various amounts of ways to help fix him. Well, to help, not fix him, but help him with his problem. And
the writing's incredible, the characters are funny. It's a good show, so you wish to come see
it. I am playing Jesse. He is a 10-year-old boy who is said to have ADD. And he's just a normal, like, kid.
It's really hard about it. I guess the hardest part is just lines. That's like the hardest part.
Oh, you should send Jesse there. It's real easy and see, like, I don't even take drugs anymore because...
You were taking drugs too?
Well, not drugs. I mean, I'm not, like, on heroin or meth or Ritalin like some other kids. Like, I had this boyfriend. He's bipolar too. He's in a band.
There's also an entry in the bathroom.
Oh.
He was opening the doors on the other kids.
Bathroom trauma at this age is not a good thing.
I know.
But just last week, kids were looking under the stalls of him.
All I'm saying is I've been teaching for 10 years, and I think getting him tested for ADD might be a good idea.
Well, thank you.
You're very welcome.
I'll be back to work.
Thanks. Very welcome. Oh, wait, I forgot to make an appointment with Dr. Waller.
Friday, February 3rd.
Great. 9 weeks from now, I call and postpone another meeting with my freelance client and head to this week's appointment with Dr. Zavala.
So, how are things going?
And he broke up with me anyway, so I took, like, 16 Tylenol, and now he's with this new girl who he thinks is so hot because she's so skinny, and the only reason why she's not fat like me is because she takes his freaking Ritalin, and she doesn't even pay for it, he just gives it to her for free, and do you have any clothes in the 60s?
Bye, Mr. Cara.
Bye.
Say hi to Jesse for me. Call me if you need to babysit.
Jesse's watching the TV upstairs and you're watching down here.
Sat with him all afternoon. Been watching the Weather Channel for 3 days.
What are you watching?
Look, if you continue to give my son drugs, I will divorce you.
Guys?
It's hard to talk about Laramie now. To tell you what Laramie is for us. If you would have asked me before, I would have told you Laramie's a beautiful town. is secluded enough that you can have your own identity. A town with a strong sense of community. Everyone knows everyone. A town with a personality that most larger cities are stripped of. And now, after Matthew, I would say that Laramie is a town defined by an accident, a crime. We become Waco. We become Jasper. We're a noun, a definition, a sign. We may be able to get rid of that, but we'll sure take a while.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Milestone Theater Company welcomes you to the world premiere of Master Mistress Muse, The Sonnets in Love. Please take this opportunity to note the exits under the lighted signs at either side of the stage marked exit.
All of these lines across my face tell you the story of who I am. So many stories of where I've been, and now I got to where I am. But these stories don't mean anything when you've got no one to tell them to. It's true.
Now, I think Marge knows a bit more what she's going
to do. I was made for you.
Where are you going with this story?
Well, we still haven't decided yet.
I climbed across the mountain tops, swam all across the ocean blue. Across all the lands and I broke all rules. And baby, I broke them all for you. Oh, because even when I was flat broke, you made me feel like a million bucks. You do. I was made for
you. The following is a statement. Family asked me once again to express their sincerest gratitude to the entire world for the absolutely overwhelming response to their son. Family is grateful that they did not have to make a decision regarding whether or not to continue life support on their son. Like a good son, he was caring to the end, and he removed guilt, stress from the family. He came into the world premature. He left the world premature. Matthew's mother said, go home. Matthew's mother said, go home. Give your kids a hug. Don't let a day go by without letting them know that you love them.
You see the smile that's on my mouth. It's hiding the words that don't come out. All of my friends who think that I'm blessed, they don't know my head is a mess. No, they don't know who I really am. Don't know what I've been through like.
I feel everyone needs to own it. We are like this. We are like this. We are like
this. Across my face, tell you the story of who I am. So many stories of where I've been.
After the show.